I'm Coach Jamie Dreyer from Overhaul Training, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to release trigger points from your rhomboids major and minor using the PUREWAVE and a tennis ball. Then, I'll go ahead and show you how you can strengthen these muscles if they're weak and stretch them if they're tight. Using the point stick on your PUREWAVE, you're going to go ahead and look for the trigger points in your rhomboids just on the inside border of your scapula. Once you find it, give it some love for about 30 seconds before moving on and looking for the next trigger point. You can also go ahead and use a tennis ball by laying it on the floor, lie on your back, wiggle around, looking around for the same tender spot, give it love for 30, and moving on. But the truth of the matter is, I don't think we engage our rhomboids enough. We spend so much time as a society, whether it's driving, typing, texting, or crocheting, most of our day is spent with the rhomboids stretched out and elongated, and then therefore they end up weak. But what we really need to do in order to have healthy rhomboids is a lot more horizontal pulling to get them strong. Now, when I say horizontal pulling, you could do vertical pulling or you can do horizontal, because this is gonna best engage your rhomboids. But be mindful. Remember, I see a lot of people at the gym doing their pulling like this. This is arm. This is a lot of arm and maybe a little bit of shoulder work, but the rhomboids pull the scapula back. So in order to actually engage them, you need to make sure that you're pulling your scapulas and kind of pinching your shoulder blades together. Together if you're doing them two arms at a time, or just get a really nice pull all the way through if you're going one arm at a time. Personally, I like dumbbells and cable pulleys best for this type of exercise. Now, if you do happen to be one of those people with tight rhomboids and notice that your shoulder blades are pulled back, or maybe one is kind of pulled up and back and you notice this posture going on a little bit, or both of them, I do have a great stretch for you. The job of the rhomboids is to pull that shoulder blade back and closer to the spine, so in order to stretch it, we need to get it farther away, right? So, the best way to do this is you can start off by just simply pulling your arm across, but I like to get a little extra resistance. So I want something that I can lean into and kind of grab onto. It can be a squat rack, a countertop, whatever it may be. I'm gonna show you how I can do this on the plyo box right now. And as I pull that arm across, I'm then gonna lean over, anchor my hand on the far side. And now I'm starting to kind of shift my weight away from the hand that's anchored. This is gonna help pull the shoulder blade a bit across. And now from here, once I'm in my best stretch, I kind of feel around for the angle, so I feel the stretch, there we go, in the middle of my shoulder blades. Now I'm gonna take my left arm, I'm currently stretching the left rhomboid, and I'm gonna pull gently into the box with my left hand. That's trying to engage my rhomboid. Hold it for 5 seconds, and then I relax, and I try and go a little farther into the stretch. You can do this 3 to 5 times, contract, relax. It's the best approach that I've found so far. If you're not sure if the issue with your rhomboids is that they're too short and tight or too long and weak, give them both a try. Why not? Experiment a little bit. See which one feels best. And if you do discover that the issue is that they're too weak, go ahead and click the link, head over to the Pectoralis Major video as well, and complement the work that you're doing with your rhomboids with loosening up the pec major. I'm Coach Jamie Dreyer, and I'll see you in the next video.